Hello everyone, welcome to Chia Chia Edu, I'm teacher Chia. Today we'll be looking at Form 1 Science Chapter 9, Earth, Part 1. Let us talk about the system and structure of the Earth. So, this is our beautiful home planet. And the planet is actually spherical. So due to the sphere-shaped nature, our Earth is actually separated into 4 different parts, namely the atmosphere, biosphere, hydrosphere, and also geosphere. Atmosphere refers to the air zone, biosphere refers to the life zone, hydrosphere refers to the water zone, and finally geosphere, our rock and soil zone. To make it easier to understand the spheres, let us look at some examples. So in atmosphere, the air zone, we are actually referring to the multiple layers of our atmosphere. We will look into this later. Next one, the biosphere, life zone. It includes humans, animals, plants, microorganisms, basically all the living things on Earth. And hydrosphere, the water zone, we have rivers, lakes, ocean, underground water, everything related to water. Finally, geosphere, we have mountains, minerals, lava, as well as the molten magma underground. Now, let us take a look at the atmosphere. Our atmosphere is roughly 400 km thick, and it is made out of layers and layers of gases that envelop the Earth and held together by gravity. As we move upwards in the atmosphere, the thinner the air gets, which lowers the air pressure. The temperature also decreases as we go up. So, the first layer we are going to learn is the troposphere, the layer where we are living in and all living organisms breathe in. This is also the layer where most climate changes occur, such as the blowing winds and the formation of clouds. Yes, you heard me right. The clouds that you thought that are really high up in the sky are actually just around the edge of troposphere, or 13 kilometers high to be more accurate. So, the weather changes that we experience all happen within the troposphere, which brings us to the next layer, stratosphere. First of all, the stratosphere's height range is around 13 to 50 kilometers, and this layer is actually highly suitable and stable for aircraft flights. This is mainly to avoid the dangers of climate changes such as strong winds, thunderstorms that occur in the troposphere. So another key component in this layer is actually the ozone layer. Some of you may have already heard about the hole in our atmosphere before this. And did you know that it is actually referring to the hole in the ozone layer? The hole was actually caused by the thinning of ozone layer due to a chemical substance known as chlorofluorocarbon, or CFC. As one of the functions of the ozone layer is to help filter the ultraviolet rays, its thinning causes issues such as global warming. So we should really reduce the use of CFC before there's no such thing as ozone layer. Next up is the mesosphere. This layer is like an armor of the Earth. In the outer space, there are meteors flying here and there, and some of them may crash into Earth. But as they enter the atmosphere, they will start burning up, and by the time they reach the mesosphere, there's usually nothing left. Only certain large meteors can make it through all the layers and hit the Earth, which forms a crater. Our fourth layer, the thermosphere, it is the thickest layer of our atmosphere. It is also known as ionosphere since it contains ions that are produced from the sun's radiation. Also, this causes the temperature to increase to a few hundred degrees Celsius. The ions are also capable of reflecting radio waves, which are used for communications and navigation. Last but not least, the famous aurora, or also known as polar lights, actually occurs in this layer. Finally, let's look at our fifth layer, the exosphere. The word exo actually means external or from outside, hence it is the most uppermost region of the Earth's atmosphere. It gradually fades into the vacuum of space, so there is actually no clear upper boundary of this layer. Only very light gases such as helium and hydrogen are found here, and the air is extremely thin. There is a very weak gravity here, and it can be made use by the satellites orbiting the Earth in this layer. So here's some fun fact. Some scientists actually consider exosphere to be part of our atmosphere, but there's actually also scientists that think that the exosphere is really just part of space. After looking at the sky, let us move to the ocean next, or more exactly, ocean stratification. So ocean made out of a very huge part of the Earth, and it can also be separated into several layers just like our atmosphere. So firstly, it is the surface zone. The surface zone, or also known as the sunlight zone, is around 0 to 200 meters deep in the sea. The water there is very shallow, so sunlight can actually penetrate to the sea. Hence, it is a suitable habitat for all the plants. And due to the existence of plants in the sunlight zone, it became the habitat for over 90% of ocean life. As we dive deeper, we'll move into the midnight zone, or also known as the twilight zone. It ranges from 200 to 1500 meters deep, and it has very little light, or basically no light. So this made it very difficult for plants to survive, and without a food source, most of the aquatic organisms choose to live in the surface zone. Only large marine animals such as giant squids or whales may displace their habitat. Lastly, as we move below 1500 meters, we will be entering the dark zone, which is very deep and no light can reach there at all. The area also suffers extremely high water pressure, and most animals found in this zone, they actually have shimmering bodies or they are able to glow in the dark. Moving on from our deep sea, let us look at how the water cycles itself around the Earth. Firstly, water gets evaporated into the sky in the form of water vapor. And due to the cooler temperature in the sky, the water vapor will form clouds through condensation. Next, the water will fall back to Earth through precipitation, either in rain form or snow form. So the water will return to the river and some of them will go underwater. Finally, they will all follow back into the ocean, forming a cycle itself. So all in all, the water on Earth actually stays constant most of the time. After talking about atmosphere and hydrosphere, we'll now move on to the geosphere. Let's look at the Earth's layers. So, if we are able to actually cut open our Earth, it will look something like this. Yes, you can see it is formed of multiple layers. Let us know the layer. Firstly, it is the Earth's crust. It is actually the outermost layer of our Earth. It is also the thinnest layer. Moving on, it's the second layer, the mantle. The mantle is actually formed from multiple layers that we will be learning soon. So let's just move on for now. Next up is the Earth's core. And the core is actually separated into the outer core as well as the inner core. It is actually the hottest part of the Earth. So let us look at the mantle now. The mantle is actually further separated into three different layers. Firstly, the lithosphere, asthenosphere, and finally, mesosphere. To know all of the layers of our Earth, let us look at the diagram next. Let us start with the crust. So, the crust is actually the thinnest outermost layer of our Earth, and it is mostly solid. The thickness is not more than 60 km, and it actually consists partially of the lithosphere. And lithosphere is actually pieces of tectonic plates that float on the asthenosphere. It is actually made out of solid matter that is cooled and pushed to the Earth's surface, which forms our crust. And asthenosphere, it is the middle layer of our mantle. It consists of semi-solid substances due to their half-molten state, and it flows and floats the tectonic plates. Lastly, in the mantle, it is the mesosphere. It is the innermost layer of mantle, and it is mostly solid. Moving on to the core, the outer core is rich in metals such as nickel and iron, but due to the high temperature, the nickel and iron are in molten form. The combination of the melting metal actually produces Earth's magnetic field. And finally, the inner core, it is the same as outer core, consisting of nickel and iron. However, due to the extremely high pressure, those iron and nickels, they are actually existing in solid form. The temperature in our inner core, it can reach 5000 degrees Celsius. So, those are basically the system and structure of the Earth that we are going to learn in 9.1. But before we end the video today, let's look at one last thing. This is our Earth. The Earth is a very special place. Firstly, it has oxygen, it has water, and the location of Earth in the solar system, it is not too near or too far from the sun. This gave us enough sunlight for the plants to perform photosynthesis. And
Earth
exists with atmosphere. It helps to regulate our Earth's climate, and the average temperature that are not too hot or too cold allow us to live on Earth. And there are many, many more characteristics that make Earth a unique planet. So, for all we know, Earth is the only home for all life forms. We should really take care of our own planet. So, this brings us to the end of Chapter 9, Part 1. As usual, I have prepared a set of notes and shared through the Google Drive link below. Please go and download, and you can do your revision on your own. That's all for our video today. I'll see you next time. Bye!